Hello, everyone. This is Rev Paul with MiraclesOne, and welcome to another episode of Miracle Flights. Today, we're going to take a look at how pilots use VORs to navigate all over the world and how the use of VORs relates to being a beacon of light in A Course in Miracles. So grab your course books and let's get started. Hello, everyone, and welcome back. What I have here is an image of a VOR. Sometimes when you're driving down the road, you'll see these. A VOR stands for VHF Omnidirectional Range. This is a navigation transmitter for pilots to use during navigation all over the world. What these do is they transmit via VHF frequencies, 360 different radials, if you will, or 360 different frequencies. And there's one frequency for each direction. For example, this is 0 degrees, and then we have one 10 degrees later, and there's actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in between. So there's 360 individual radials or beams being broadcasted out from the center of the VOR. And you can see our little airplane up here is on one of those radios. And inside of the cockpit in that airplane, that pilot has an instrument that looks like this. This is called a course deviation indicator. And you can see that it has a compass rose around it, a compass card that has all of the radials on it. It has this white bar here that hangs down from the top, and that swings left and right like a windshield wiper. And that's called a course deviation indicator. And then you also have this omni bearing selector here. But basically, think of that little donut in the middle here as an airplane. And what you do, if you want to follow a particular radial going to a VOR, you rotate this OBS knob and you rotate the radial that you want to start following straight to the VOR, and you put it at the top here. So in this case, we've dialed up north. And what this is, or the 360 degree radial, and in this case, if the airplane was actually on that radial, that specific radial, that needle would be straight up and down across that donut there. And that would indicate that the airplane is exactly on the course. When the needle slides to one direction or the other, as it is indicating here, for example, the airplane is showing to the right of the course, that means that the airplane needs to fly a little bit to the left to get back on the course and start to track that specific radial to the VOR. And here's another picture that I'm going to put on the map here. So this is an air chart that shows a whole bunch of VORs that are plotted all over the United States. So I'm going to point here. There's a little compass rose right here, and there's a VOR in the middle of it. That's broadcasting 365 radials. There's another one right here. There's another one right here. That's Chicago area. And you could see there's more here, and you can see the airways in between them. A lot of times the VORs are actually located on the specific airport, and they're broadcasting outward, and what pilots often do is they're following a VOR radial to their home base, to their home station. And what I want to do, so think about this as we transition into our discussion around A Course in Miracles. Think of a VOR kind of like as a lighthouse here. We have a lighthouse, and the lighthouse has a rotating beacon, and it's shining light in all directions. It rotates in this circle, and that's a beam of light or radials kind of going out too, right? So as we move into our reading today, which is going to be The Obstacles to Peace, which is in chapter 19, section 4, Jesus talks about this idea that we have been given this beacon of light, this beacon of peace inside of us. So I want to invite everyone to think of themselves symbolically kind of as like a VOR, and with these radials that it's broadcasting out to help everyone come home. We individual human beings on the planet here going through this experience have this inner peace, this beacon of light peace that has been put inside of us at our creation. We will never lose it. And when we come in within the illusion, things begin to happen where we're blocking that light. We don't realize this is happening. Jesus discusses in this area these obstacles to peace, these obstacles to us shining our light out. And it's really neat here, some of the things he says here in The Obstacles to Peace. In the very first paragraph, the peace he lay deep within you and your brother will quietly extend to every aspect of your life, surrounding you and your brother with glowing happiness and the calm awareness of complete protection. So this is inside of us, and we can't allow it to extend out, but we're blocking it unconsciously with a lot of obstacles, which he's going to go into a discussion about here. In paragraph 2, he gives us the solution, kind of a hint to the solution of how do we get by these obstacles that we're projecting and preventing our light from shining and helping everyone to come home with us. And it's by the Holy Spirit asks that you offer him a resting place where you will rest in him. He answered you and entered your relationship. Would you not now return his graciousness and enter into a relationship with him? So he's giving us a hint here that the kind of the way out of this problem is to go within and connect with the Holy Spirit and ask him to start helping us, to give us some gifts to move beyond these obstacles that we're putting on ourselves. And he's going to go way into that more. By the way, The Obstacles to Peace is going to take us several weeks to work through. It's a very long piece. You cannot see the Holy Spirit, but you can see your brothers truly, and the light in them will show you all that you need to see. When the peace in you has been extended to encompass everyone, the Holy Spirit's function here will be accomplished. All right. So here's a great segue, or, you know, he's referring to this inner light that we have. All right. We can't see the Holy Spirit, but we can see our brothers truly, and the light in them will show you all that you need to see. So he's referring to the gift of vision here. All right. And when we go within with the Holy Spirit, we can learn how to receive this gift of vision of seeing our inner light, seeing the light within others. OK, in the very first paragraph of The Obstacles to Peace, he says that we are the center from which the light or the peace radiates outward to call the others in. We are peace's home. We are the light's home, its tranquil dwelling place from which it gently reaches out, but never leaving us. If it would spread across the whole creation, it must begin with you, and from you reach to everyone who calls and bring him rest by joining you. So I go back to this air chart on the back here. I want you to kind of think of ourselves now for this lesson that we're kind of like these VORs. We're these beacons of light within the world, and we can learn how to allow those radials of light to shine more brightly from us by working with the Holy Spirit, by finding that inner light. And when that happens, we automatically radiate more peace. We automatically radiate more light. And that light, those radials of light, those radials of peace automatically attract others, or those who are still blocking their light and aren't aware that they too are beacons of light in the world. And they'll start to migrate home with us. They'll start to migrate toward us. They'll come into our lives, all right? And it's our job to help awaken ourselves up and find this inner light through the gift of vision with the Holy Spirit. And then once we do that, we automatically are going to help others to find it. So when you begin to look at the obstacles of peace, like right now, just read those three paragraphs in the introduction and take a look at the first paragraph. And then I want you to go to lesson 188, which is the peace of God is shining in me now. Because as we move into examining the obstacles to peace, which is a very lengthy discussion, and the discussion describes the problems, and intermixed in there, Jesus describes the answer. And the answer, a great tool for working on the answer and the solution, is found in this lesson 188, the peace of God is shining in me now, because he very specifically in this lesson talks about this light, this inner peace that we have, that he's talking about in the obstacles, in the introduction, the obstacles of peace. You who bear the light in you, the light came with you from your native home. It is your own. It shines in you. This light cannot be lost, and it can be so easily looked upon. All right. It is not difficult to look within, for there all vision starts, there perception starts. So in this lesson, he very specifically invites us to close our eyes and sit quietly and go within and to practice joining with the Holy Spirit and asking the Holy Spirit for the gift of vision to help us to have the actual experience of perceiving the light inside of us, using our spiritual sight. And it's also, we're also going to have an automatic recognition that this is the same light that's in everyone else. And this is not a metaphor. This is a literal thing that he's actually trying to help us to learn how to do and to experience. And then once that happens, we are going to automatically have a mind healing that projects us to a whole new level, because we know what's there. We know heaven's inside of us. We know that the light, the source of light, is inside of us, and that it's who we really are. And we automatically begin to share that peace and that joy with everyone else. And then we start to attract them to us with that peace that they start to sense and pick up on. And then it helps them to awaken. And this all helps us to find our way home. Okay, so great lesson. I encourage everyone to work with this, not only this week, but to continue to use it as a tool to find that inner peace, that inner light, have that experience, so that we can move through our obstacles much more quickly as we study what they are in the upcoming weeks. All right, so thank you everyone for joining with me today, and you are cleared for landing. We'll see you again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.